Hi, boys and girls. As you know, this week we have been reading Three Billy Goats Fluff. And so today we are going to read another version of the same story, only this one's called Three Billy Goats Gruff. And this one is the more traditional tale that more people commonly know. So I'm going to read it to you. It's called Three Billy Goats Gruff. It says, "Once upon a time, there were three billy goats gruff who lived on a hillside next to a wide, deep stream." As we read, we're going to pay attention to what's the same and what's different from Three Billy Goats Fluff. On the other side of the stream was a big field of sweet green grass. Every day, the three billy goats gruff looked hungrily at the field on the other side of the stream. Every day, they longed to eat some of the sweet green grass. But to get to the other side of the stream, they had to cross a wooden bridge. And under the bridge lived a horrible, mean troll. One day, the littlest billy goat gruff said, "I cannot wait any longer. I am going to cross the bridge and eat the sweet green grass." "We will come too," said his brothers. "We will be right behind you." Little Billy Goat Gruff started across the bridge. Trip-trap, trip-trap went his little hooves on the planks of wood. "Who is that trip-trapping over my bridge?" said the troll. "It is I, Little Billy Goat Gruff," said the Little Billy Goat Gruff in his wee small voice. "I am coming up to eat you," roared the troll. Little Billy Goat Gruff was afraid. "Oh, please don't eat me," he said. "Wait for my big brother. He is much larger and tastier than I am." "Very well," said the troll, licking his lips. "You may go ahead." So Little Billy Goat Gruff crossed the bridge safely and got to the field on the other side. Then Middle Billy Goat Gruff started across the bridge. Trip-trap, trip-trap went his middle-sized hooves on the planks of wood. "Who is that trip-trapping over my bridge?" called the troll. "It is I, Middle Billy Goat Gruff," said the Middle Billy Goat Gruff in his middle-sized voice. "I am coming up to eat you," roared the troll. Middle Billy Goat Gruff was afraid. "Please don't eat me," he said. "Wait for my big brother. He is much larger and tastier than I." "Very well," said the troll, thinking of the fine meal he would have. "You may go ahead." So Middle Billy Goat Gruff crossed the bridge safely and got to the field on the other side. Then Big Billy Goat Gruff started across the bridge. Trip-trap. Trip-trap went his big hooves on the planks of wood. The whole bridge shook with his weight. "Who is that trip-trapping over my bridge?" roared the troll in his loudest voice. "It is I, Big Billy Goat Gruff," shouted Big Billy Goat Gruff in his loudest voice. "I suppose you are going to tell me to wait for your big brother," said the troll. "Oh, no," said Big Billy Goat Gruff. "I am the biggest one there is." "Then I am coming up to eat you," the troll shouted, and he climbed onto the bridge. Big Billy Goat Gruff was not afraid. "I would like to see you try," he said. He rushed at the troll and butted him with his horns. The troll fell off the bridge and disappeared, leaving no trace. After that, the three Billy Goats Gruff crossed the bridge whenever they liked and ate their fill of sweet green grass. And the horrible, mean troll was never there to bother them again. The end. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to talk about how Three Billy Goats Fluff and Three Billy Goats Gruff are the same and how they're different. So let's first talk about how they're the same. Okay, so in both books, we have three goats, right? But how are the goats a little bit different in how they're illustrated in each story? In the first one that we read in class on Monday and Tuesday in Three Billy Goats Gruff, their mom had a knitting business, right? And so they ate the green grass so that their coats would be nice and shiny and fluffy for their mom's knitting business. In Three Billy Goats Gruff, the three goats were trying to get to the sweet green grass. In both stories, there was a troll living under the bridge, wasn't there? And he was mean in both of the books. However, it was different because in Three Billy Goats Fluff, they dealt with it in a different way. Do you remember how they dealt with the troll? Their mom knitted them booties, right? That would make, as their feet went over the bridge, it made their feet quieter. And so that way the troll wouldn't have to listen to them trip-trapping over the bridge. And they also gave the troll a gift. What did they give the troll? They gave him earmuffs, right? That way he didn't have to hear them trip-trapping over the bridge. And so when he had the earmuffs, he was able to sleep quietly. All right, and then in Three Billy Goats Gruff, how did they get rid of the troll or deal with the troll? They crossed one at a time, right? And the biggest Billy Goat Gruff, he was able to push the troll off the bridge, and he was able to make it so that the troll went away and never came back. So in both stories, they were able to deal with the troll, but it was in a little bit of a different way. I hope you enjoyed comparing and contrasting Three Billy Goats Fluff with Three Billy Goats Gruff. I'll see you later.